Hi everyone, Ulysses here for Microchip Technology. Welcome back to Ask Our Experts, a series of videos where we answer some frequently asked questions on a wide variety of topics. Today's topic is on secure elements, and to help answer our question, Todd Slack joins us again. So let's get into it. Todd, the EN303645 is a European standard that is being looked at by the EU governments to create legislation for consumer IoT products. Can you tell us the impact that it will have for our customers?
Well, to answer that, I think we actually start off in the UK. The UK really pioneered some efforts in the IoT space with the IoT Security Foundation coming up with 13 core principles in IoT security. A number of these principles we believe are directly associated with or rely on a secure element like our crypto authentication family or our crypto automotive family. So you can see some of these boxes that we have here highlighted in yellow would have a direct association there. But overall, there are 13 principles, and they start with three core principles. The first one being no default passwords. That's very bad hygiene because hackers, if they know that, could connect to the network and then take over a device even with administrator rights. The second one is to have a vulnerability disclosure process, which Microchip has covered with our PCERT, Product Security Incident Response Team. This is available online so that outside sources can log into Microchip and submit vulnerabilities that they may have discovered. And then our PCERT team would review the submission. And if it is determined that actually this is a vulnerability, then we would go through a process to determine kind of what level of vulnerability is it, how severe is it. And then once we figure that out, the team would put together some response and review and documentation that ultimately we can make available to our customers either on the website or directly to customers in conversation who might be impacted by it. The third core component is to keep your software updated. So that ties into things like secure firmware upgrade, which has a clear tie into something like a secure element where keys are associated with signature verification of incoming encrypted firmware payloads before that firmware can be updated. But it's important that it can be updated. Personal data is getting more attention, but from the UK's point of view, in 2022, what they're trying to do is legislate, make it required by law that when building IoT devices, that you have those three first core principles covered with no password, default passwords, vulnerability incident response teams, and software updates. Now, in the European standard, you have the EN303645, which is pretty much a mirror of the UK initiative. They also have 13 principles, just with different numbers within the specification, and most of the language in those principles is actually identical. So it can be difficult for ODMs or tier ones to really follow all these principles and understand them. One of the things that Microchip has done to make that more simplified is we put together a blog application note surrounding basically how you can categorize your risk assessment, how you can fix that or mitigate those risks with a secure element on each of the features that are listed in the specification. So we can make your life easier when trying to follow these standards in both the UK and Europe, and we certainly see them expanding around the globe as well.
Thanks, Todd. For our viewers, if you would like to learn more, make sure to check out our Trust Platform webpage linked in the description below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.